Hello everyone, I'm back, and today I'm back as a parent and a facilitator, and I just want to talk to parents specifically about some things. We're all going through these hard times, and our children have not lived such harsh life ever. How do we help them to respond to these times positively? There's so many questions on our minds as parents and as facilitators. Am I doing this right? What if this happens? What if this doesn't go right? I remember my time as a mother of a young growing boy and how I would react to situations. Well, when I look back and think, there were things I did right and some I didn't do the right way. But isn't that what parenting is all about? You make your own plans and scripts and then modify them on the journey of parenthood. However, one thing that remains constant is skill building in a child. Your child may score top results, achieve laurels, but if skills are lacking, then they struggle as adults. In today's times and context, it is imperative we focus on building skills and developing areas beyond intellect. It is important to draw our focus towards emotional, social quotients in young learners and building resilience in them. A resilient mind can strive to achieve anything because success and failures drive them equally. They have something to learn from both. Right from childhood, we need to start building resiliency in children. Teach them that it's okay to fail. But after failing, you need to find the reasons of failure and rectify them and work again and move on further. Teach them to keep striving towards their goals and not give up midway. Children who take up competitive sports from young ages know how to handle failures and work harder the next time. Sports teaches you to take success and failures in the same stride and build your capabilities. I'm yet to come across a sportsman who gives up easily. We tell children to show sportsman spirit, but what does it really mean? Do we ever tell them that if you came second, third or last, it doesn't matter. Figure out why you came. And then work towards improving your skills. Work towards working on those skills and moving ahead. We give too much to our children, even before they ask for it or need it or want it. We should let them want and work towards getting something, not give it to them easily. It will help them. Believe me when I say that, as a parent, now I'm a parent of a 22-year-old who's grown up into a young adult. And when I look back and think, was I too harsh on him on some areas? And then I tell myself, no, I think it was a good thing that I did, that I'm being harsh with my child in some areas and saying no for things.